Got it. Walked back to the store. I give it to the owner. I go, you can press charges if you want. I'll take the rap, but I can either pay for this or you take it. We're good, but we just want to make whole right now. And my brother learned a lesson that day. You know what I'm saying? Like, he probably got used to the environment to get used to doing it, but sometimes people need help, you know? And that decision could end up, you know, you can be in jail. You just name it. I mean, it's just, you start making those bad decisions, you're going to end up either in jail or you're going to end up dead somewhere. You know, definitely not the direction that we talked about earlier. We want to be aiming at that direction, not that way. We may not know what it looks like yet, but we definitely don't want to make decisions that keep pushing us that way. Because that's not going to get you, that's not going to make you a happy person in life. The third thing, respect for authority. Now, authority can be your parents, it can be your teachers, it can be a police officer, it can be your colleagues, but just having respect for authority is the beginning for you, for knowledge, it's the beginning for you to start. It's respectful to do. I mean, you're respecting authority, but I mean, you gotta think about the people that are around you. I couldn't do everything I could by myself. I had people that helped me along the way. And people are not willing to help someone that they don't feel respected by. Does that make any sense? I can guarantee you that your teachers are not sitting here working up every day making lesson plans, grading papers over the weekend because of the money. There's something inside of them that's bigger than money. They're here because they want to make a difference in life. And they're working really hard. And so, you know, even if you have a problem against, say, maybe police officers, right? Maybe you have a bad situation and you just don't like police officers, right? But the bottom line is that same police officer can be saving your life another day. He's putting on his uniform. He's got his kids. And every day he's going out there with the risk of getting hit, getting shot, or getting killed. That deserves respect. You know, and that doesn't mean like, hey, I want to worship you. But you know what? Show some respect. You know? You just show some respect to your teachers. It's going to do a couple of things. Number one, it's going to make them feel good. You're throwing out positive energy to them. Number two, you're going to feel good about it because you're acknowledging it. But it's like you're throwing a lot of good karma. You know what I'm saying? So if you have a respect for authority, then you're letting yourself give them the opportunity to get. If you need help from that person's going to do everything they can to help you out if you're respectful to them. You know, people want to help you. People want to see you succeed. You know, we've got. You know, people want to. We have so many resources here that maybe some kids in Iraq don't have. You know, so it's all. I'm not judging anything. I'm just saying that it's all relative here. So, and then the last part here. A couple more quotes I just want to put in here. We talk about disadvantage from the beginning, right? I don't know if you guys ever seen a flower grow from the ground. I see this kind of quite often, especially weeds, right? They grow like there's no tomorrow. But I wanted this image to stay with you because if you feel like you're disadvantaged, if you're here at Lloyd or you're missing a credits or something happened, you know, that should not stop you from doing whatever you want to do in life. And whether it's going to school, going to college, getting started your own company, there's absolutely nothing. The only person that can stop yourself at that point is going to be you. And then this is another quick quote. Everyone's got a story, I guarantee it. Dr. Nelman has a story, I'm sure. Each one of us, if we were up here talking about your story, I happen to be sharing mine right now, but I'm sure we all have our very story. And we can talk about my moments with my Nick one five pennies. You have that story somewhere inside of you, you know? And the most important thing, and I don't know if you have a piece of paper, but if you do, can you pull it out now? Pull it out. Piece of paper, I don't care how big it is, how small it is. And I want you to copy this right here. And do it as fast as you can. Here. I want you to write this down. And when you're done, just give me the thumbs up.
Write it down. It's not what happens to you.
So I want you to get that piece of paper up in the air. I want to see when you finish writing it. I want to make sure I see it. This is going to be really interesting. So cut it out, and I want you to fold it in a nice little square. And I want you to put this in the back of your pocket. And just leave it there all day. And if you can't, if you have a wallet, put it in your wallet. Or put it in your purse. But try to keep that wherever you go. Because this is going to be probably one of the most important things out of the entire thing today.